Carving the Divine is the first documentary to provide a behind-the-scenes look at the next generation of Bushis, learning their craft from giving yet stern masters. The feature does not paint a picture of Zen tranquility, but one of agonizing pain as the apprentices train to hone their handiwork. Yujiro Seki is here with me. Thanks for coming on to Showcase. So, before everything else, what exactly is the craft of Bushi? Can you please enlighten us?
That's a very difficult question. Of course, it's 1,400 years of tradition. I don't even know where to start. So that's why nobody has made a movie about before.
Okay, I have an idea. China and Korea, they have the same tradition too, right? What sets Bushi apart from other sculpture traditions?
Okay, so initially, the tradition was an imitation of Korea and China counterpart. You know, China as a big country, we always got the inspiration from China. But about the year 1000, so slowly Japanese people started implementing on their own style. And the tradition is to keep the style no matter what.
So there was a diplomatic break between China and Japan back then, wasn't
yes,
there?
Yes. That's one of the reasons. And there's one genius showed up and he changed the game as well.
Okay, so we do know so much about Japanese culture. I mean, in the Western world and also globally, you know, from philosophy to design to lifestyle. But I think this tradition, Bushi, stayed a bit under the shadow. Why do you think so?
Well, because it's just like an air for Japanese people. So, you know, for Japanese people, we celebrate it, we worship it, but, you know, we don't think too much of it. So, you know, because we don't think so much of it, just like air, if somebody cut it off, we're gonna choke. We're gonna get choked. But until somebody cut it off, probably we don't notice how important it is.
But you did. Tell me why you wanted to make a documentary about this.
Because I had an opportunity to go to the United States and study cinema there. So, to make a long story short, when I was little, I was surrounded by Buddhist objects because my father is a Buddhist furniture maker, and he took me to different temples all over the place. And I didn't really think of that environment that I grew up in was somewhat very special. Mm-hmm. But I saw Japan from outside for the first time when I went to the United States, meeting people from different cultures. And I realized the environment grew up in was somewhat very special. So if I wanted to make a documentary, spending next precious few years of my life, I wanted to do something meaningful.
How many years did it take?
7 years.
7 years?
Yes.
And you did pretty much everything. Okay, you're the director, cinematographer, editor, dialogue translator, writer, and producer. I mean, why did you do this?
Well, you know, as a young person, I was inspired by one of the famous directors, Roberto Rodriguez from the United States.
Okay.
And he made an entire feature film by himself. And it was very inspirational. And as a young person, I thought I could do the same. I don't need anybody else. I wanted to work on this art. And I don't want to get influenced by big people and big money. That's why I started doing
it. And how did it work out for you?
Well, I don't know if I want to do this ever again. That's the honest answer. But, you know, I'm very pleased because I can wholeheartedly believe in this project now. And I can tell authentic story of Japan. And if I don't make another film for the rest of my life, I have no regret because I really believe in it.
And this is your first movie, isn't it?
First feature documentary, yes.
First feature documentary. Okay, so the master-student relationship in the training of Bushi. That is really interesting for me because it's so authoritarian. It is, you know, what we know about Buddhism from the very outside, from the very surface, it really contradicts it in my eyes. So please tell me how the training works for Bushis.
Well, it's interesting. It seems like it has nothing to do with Buddhism because, you know, the point is to be as good as possible. The point is to be a master carver. It's not about to have a self-actualization or, you know, become a Zen master or anything like that. But, you know, apprentices, they go into the field and they completely have to obey the master. They kind of get rid of all the self. You know, if you talk back to your master, you are fired. The masters will tell you, don't come back, right? In order for them to really keep going and become a great wood carver, is to stick with it. In a sense, it's a self-destruction of themselves.
And how long does this last for?
Well, it depends. 3 years, 5 years, sometimes 10 years. And, you know, depends on the skills of the apprentices. Some people, some apprentices get better faster than the other. So it's hard to say, but, you know, in a sense, everybody is apprentice for the rest of their lives because it's never enough. Even the master Saito, that who's in the movie, he always says, I don't want to make anything embarrassing.
Well, years of obedience, I mean, this is quite tough. Do you think, I mean, it is a 1,400 years of tradition, quite old tradition. Mm. Do you think it's still as popular in Japan as it was 1,000 years ago, say?
Well, here's the thing. I think it's as I say, it's like an air. Of course, probably when people have more difficult times, they rely on a higher power. So, you know, nowadays, Japan have a tendency to focus on technology, a new invention. That's what Japan is about. And we are kind of forgetting about what our ancestors valued in the past. And this tradition, Buddhist sculptor, is a very, very deep tradition. I made a documentary about the Busshi, but I haven't even touched the surface of what tradition can even teach people. So when you think about it, when you watch this documentary, I hope this is going to be the launching point for people to know more about this beautiful culture. And when you go to Kyoto, Japan, I want them to see the statues in a different way.
And maybe you will come up with more features about the Busshi, Yujiro Seki. It was great to have you on our show today. Thank you so much.
Beautiful. Thank you so much for having me.